Hey everybody, it's Jang here from JANGBRiCKS.com with a look at the official LEGO combination model between the Evo Walker, the small one, and the Furno jet machine. So since the Evo Walker is so small, obviously most of the parts here, or the majority of the parts here, are from the Furno jet machine. No surprise there, but I am very happy with how they've combined these things together because the two original models look very different, but they've combined them together into something that looks like it could have been real. You know, it fits into the theme very well, I think. It's different to have the twin operators there, but I think it actually works out okay, you know. And the good thing is that they've done what you absolutely need to do when you combine two things together in a war sort of situation, in a battle situation. You need to take the primary offensive systems of both and put them together. So that's exactly what they've done here. You've got the flame cannon on one arm, and then you've got the goose shooter on the other arm. And there are enough joints on these arms, you know, enough bone pieces that you can get plenty of articulation. You can go all the way over the head. You can bring that all the way back. These kind of, I guess they're supposed to be engines, are able to still rotate like they should. So I'm assuming that this would still be able to, you know, take off slowly and hover and kind of move around in the air a little bit. Has a very nice build to the body. I'm surprised I didn't think of this myself earlier for using that piece right there as the hips and kind of the core holding the whole body together. They just attached that to a regular torso piece and then attached everything else to that. And that's a very good use of the ball and socket joint system to give you a different style of body. I like that quite a lot. This is the design element that I don't like out of all of them. You just have this open space here, but it really doesn't bug me because only if you look at it directly from the side do you even notice that, because I think they have enough armor used throughout this thing, good pairings of armor to bone length, and I'm pretty happy with this thing. The only thing that's objectively suboptimal about this design is that you do have these ball ends, the full ball ends at the ends of the upper legs, and unfortunately there's not a lot of front to back friction when you use those. So this thing is a little bit tough to pose sometimes, or it'll want to fall back, it'll want to fall forward, just a little bit low on friction there. And can just make it a little bit frustrating to get exactly the pose that you want, but it's not too bad. You know, there aren't too many pieces here, so this thing isn't too heavy. It's not too heavy for the joints. It's just a little bit close to marginal on that. But overall, I'm still very happy with this thing. The official building instructions are on LEGO's website, and the reviews for the individual sets to begin with are already done. They're on my channel, so you can check those out. You can see the other combination models, and who knows, maybe I'll do some combination, you know, custom combinations of my own. But that's it for this video. Thank you for watching, and I'll talk to you again soon.